Hachette Audio presents Going to Pot: Why the Rush to Legalize Marijuana is Harming America. Written by William J. Bennett and Robert A. White. Read by Kevin Stillwell. Includes a Mac and PC compatible PDF of supplementary content. We dedicate this book to the men and women who serve on the front lines in the war on drugs at the local, state, and federal level. Their hard work, courage, and sacrifices deserve our gratitude and respect. Introduction. We are at a curious as well as critical moment in our country. Just when we are spending more than ever on early childhood education, and many are arguing for even more spending, just when we are debating the intellectual and motivational needs of our present and future workforce, just as we are concerned about unemployment numbers that are too high, especially in the youth and young adult population, just as we are unveiling a new experiment on universal health care coverage, and just as we are condemning other products deemed unhealthy, like sugars and trans fats, we are, at the exact same time, moving in fact and opinion toward more and more marijuana legalization. We are spending money and political capital on strengthening the health, education, and productivity of our populace. Yet society believes it appropriate to push for greater availability of a drug that hinders and negatively affects, perhaps dramatically, those very efforts. Over the past several years, as public opinion has moved toward greater acceptance of marijuana, an increasing body of scientific evidence has documented the multiple adverse effects of marijuana use. These serious health issues are detailed in an excellent article produced by the National Institute on Drug Abuse and published in the June 2014 issue of the New England Journal of Medicine. We believe this article should be read by everyone, particularly proponents of legalization, and so we have included it in our appendix, which can be found beginning on page 14 of your companion PDF. The negative consequences of marijuana legalization, particularly those experienced by adolescents, are too crucial to ignore. Table 1 of that article, a variety of short and long-term effects, should give pause to anyone who might believe that smoking marijuana is harmless. Increased knowledge of the dangers. On an almost weekly basis, medical researchers, aided by advanced technology not available decades ago, are expanding our knowledge of the negative health consequences of smoking marijuana. As we will discuss in more detail in later chapters, more than smoking tobacco or drinking alcohol, smoking marijuana can damage the heart, lungs, and brain. Moreover, it immediately impairs cognitive abilities and motor coordination, interfering with the smoker's judgment, driving skills, and other basic abilities. Normal development of the adolescent brain is at particularly high risk. Smoking marijuana deposits more tar into the lungs than smoking a cigarette, and there are numerous cancer-causing chemicals in marijuana. There is nearly a five-fold increase in the risk of heart attack in the first hour after smoking marijuana. It is a bitter irony that as our knowledge increases regarding the harm that smoking marijuana does to our health, public perception of those injuries decreases. It is our purpose in this audiobook to inform an uninformed and sometimes misinformed public about the true risks of legalization. Increased potency. We believe the debate over legalization may, in some places, be the result of two different groups talking past each other. One group, supporting legalization, either tacitly or vociferously, is thinking of the marijuana of low tetrahydrocannabinol, THC, percentiles many people now in their 50s, 60s, and 70s smoked or tried when they were in college, or for that matter, marijuana they knew from the 1970s and 1980s that was far less potent than today's marijuana, THC being the psychoactive ingredient in marijuana. It may be difficult for people who tried or used a weaker substance to see how legalizing that substance can be so harmful. The problem is that you cannot consider it the same substance when you look at the dramatic increase in potency and the increased negative neurological and other health effects arising from higher THC levels. The point is that there really are two different kinds of marijuana, and thus, perhaps, two different conversations taking place. One is based on a frame of reference of marijuana that was experienced in the past, was weaker, and does not exist today. The other is based on the reality of the marijuana that is grown, processed, and sold today. Many we have talked to are simply unaware of the potency of today's marijuana. Most who have not smoked or looked at marijuana and its potency in a very long time are surprised to realize that the marijuana they knew in the 1970s or 1980s was much less potent than it is now. The levels of THC then were in the low single digits. Today's marijuana THC levels are in the double digits. We've gone from about 3 to 5% THC in yesteryear's marijuana to just above 13% THC. But common strains are available that go much higher, into the 20% and beyond. The difference between 3 to 5% THC and 13 to 30% THC is very significant. It is like comparing a 12-ounce glass of beer with a 12-ounce glass of 80-proof vodka. Both contain alcohol, but they have vastly different effects on the body when consumed. Indeed, many argue that because of the difference in potency, it is not even the same drug we once knew. Some have taken to calling today's marijuana industrial marijuana or turbo pot. For these and many other reasons, it is our view that the effort to legalize marijuana needs to be addressed head-on, that if it is not stopped, we will soon look back and ask, what were we thinking? We believe marijuana is dangerous and should remain illegal. We also believe most of the arguments in favor of legalization are fallacious. With this audiobook, we hope to join a debate over legalization that simply has been too silent or cowed into silence on our side. We make no bones about this, as, in short, we think the effort to legalize marijuana is as irrational as any effort to legalize cigarettes would be, were they illegal here. Engage with us in a hypothetical. Assume that cigarettes are not legal and never have been in America, but tens of thousands of packs of cigarettes make it into the United States every year, made in Mexico, Canada, and other countries, and are purchased illegally on the black market. Teenagers and adults smoke them. Now, imagine there is a bill in Congress to forego all the enforcement costs of trying to keep cigarettes out of the hands and lungs of Americans by legalizing cigarettes here. Arguments on behalf of cigarette legalization seem to be gaining ground and even make some sense. We would save money on enforcement of the law against selling and smoking cigarettes. We can tax the sales to increase both state and federal revenues. And some doctors even say there can be benefits to smoking, to stave off Alzheimer's disease or decrease stress, for example, which some studies actually support. As some would argue in this scenario, there are no known risks to the brain from nicotine and tobacco inhalation. Here's the question. With today's understanding of the dangers of cigarette smoking, would you support such hypothetical legislation? Every argument we make was once true of cigarettes. Some doctors even recommended smoking and endorsed certain brands of cigarettes. Yes, cigarette sales are taxed at the state and federal levels. And no, we do not see much impairment to the brain from smoking, making it nearly impossible, aside from smell, to discern who, in any given group of people, may have just smoked a cigarette. Be that person driving a car, flying an airplane, playing cards, or giving a business presentation. The path to legalization.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.